ओम नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो सिद्धभ्यो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरेतज्ञानं जगत्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तन्तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यानस्मद्गुरून् सन्ततमानतोऽस्मि श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सहनावतु सहनं भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावः संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूचनस्य यद्ब्रह्मदीजनितसौख्यमभूच तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरी सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकचाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिम् So the Akshepa Bhashya is over, wherein the first sentence of the till Mithya Bhavitum Yuktam was dealt with. Mithya Iti Bhavitum Yuktam was dealt with. Now, moving on to the next sentence, there is an introduction. So there is an introduction. The Tika, the introduction says, Atman Atmanoho. वास्तव इक्यादो युक्त्यभावादेव अनुभव सिद्ध अध्यास अपलापे अनुभव सिद्ध घटादि पदार्थानां अपलाप प्रसंगः तथा च शून्यमत प्रवेशः स्याद् इत्यतः अनुभव सिद्धत्वाद् वास्तव ऐक्याभावे अपि सामग्री सत्वाच्च अध्यासोऽस्ति इति विषयादि संभवेन शास्त्रारंभो युक्त इति सिद्धान्तयितुं पूर्वपक्षस्य दौर्बल्यं विवृणोति तथा इति. सो व्हाट वाज सेड इज दैट सो फार व्हाट वाज सेड इन दी रत्नप्रभा एंड टीका बेस्ड ऑन दी भाष्य इज दैट अध्यास ऑफ अनात्मा एंड इट्स धर्मास ऑन आत्मा एंड इट्स धर्म स्वरूप धर्म ऑन अनात्मा इज नॉट पॉसिबल नास्ति मिथ्या एंड भवितुम युक्तम वॉज मेंशन इट वॉज सेड एज शुडेंट बी सो वॉट इट मीन्स इज दैट शुडेंट बी सो मीन्स इट शुडेंट बी सो बट इट इज सो ऑल्दो इट शुडेंट बी सो स्टिल देर इज अध्यास अदरवाइज वॉट विल हैपन दैट इज मेंशन इन द पूर्णानंदीय हियर इफ देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ वास्तव ऐक्य And tadatmya sambandha is also not possible. Therefore, between atma and anatma, if there is no adhyasa also possible, based on that, what can you conclude? Now, there is anubhava of adhyasa. That will be shown further. But if the anubhava being there, if you are questioning logically and concluding, yes, logically it shouldn't be. But Anubhava tells you otherwise that it is there. There is Adhyasa. And in case you put your logic above Anubhava and make a statement which is false. So that is the Apalapa here. If the Adhyasa isn't there is a claim. Mithya meaning Nasti. Adhyaso Nasti. Why? Logically, it shouldn't be there because of tamah prakashavat viruddha svabhavatvat. Then, anubhava siddha ghatadi padarthanam apalapa prasangaha. Then, ghatapatadi prapancha anubhava is there. You don't need to talk about superimposition. You don't need to talk about adhyasa on atma anymore. If you deny the adhyasa of ahankaradi on Atma, at least that part if you deny, then that is Anubhava Siddha. And if you give a possibility to logically establish something against the Anubhava, then you can logically establish Ghatapatadi Prapancha also being not there, Nasti. Not technical mithya, Nasti. Shunyavada. That is Anubhava Siddha, because if one Anubhava Siddha can be countered by some kind of a logic, then the Bahya Prapancha, Buddhists also say, it is Anubhava Siddha, but what do they say? It is not there. Shunyavadin say that, thereby the Siddhanti tells the Puropakshi, if you go against what is Anubhava Siddha and established as Adhyasa is not possible, then Prapancha also Anubhava Siddha you can establish as not being there, and then you will land into Shunyavada. Thereby what will happen? Shunya Mata Pravesha Syad. Your objection, you may be saying that Shastra Arambha should not be done, but if we give in to that, then we both will land into Shunyavada. It is not Ishta for either, Anishta. Because we both are what? We are Astikas. Therefore, Anubhava Siddhatvad, Anubhava Siddhatvad, Vastavaikya Bhavepi, even if there is no Vastavaikya, still between Atma and Anatma there is Samagri Sattvachya. And since there is Samagri Sattva, what is to be accepted? Adhyasa Asti. Iti Vishayadi Sambhavane. This Adhyasa is possible, therefore there is Vishaya. And if there is Vishaya, then Shastra has Prayojana also, which has been established. How? Vishaya is Adhyasa. Adhyasa of Atma on Anatma, and Viveka can be taught. Then Aikya can be taught between Atma and Brahma, thereby there will be Dukkha Nivrutti by Adhyasa Nivrutti, Jnanena, which was objected to by the Puropakshi as Jnanat Nivrutti na Sambhavati. Why? Satyataya. Bandhasya Satyataya. Now Bandha is no longer Satya, it is Adhyasa, Adhyasta Bandha. So it will go by Jnana, and therefore Vishaya being possible, Shastra Arambha Yukta Iti. This is a Siddhanta. So Siddhanta Itum meaning to show that this is a Siddhanta. Puropakshasya Daurbalyam Vivranoti. This is the weakness in the argument of Puropaksha so far as Tathaiti. Tathahi, in the Ratna Prabha, Tathahi, Kim Adhyasasya Nastitvam Ayuktatvad Abhanadva Karanabhavadva. Are you saying Adhyasa Mithya meaning Nasti? Adhyasa isn't there. Do you mean to say Adhyasa is not there because of one of these three reasons? Which of the three reasons? Why do you say Adhyasa is not possible? And still, not being possible, Anubhava Siddha also you are denying it. What is the reason for the denial? So, Nastitvam is, Adhyasasya Nastitvam is it? He makes three options. Siddhanti asks the Puropakshi, Ayuktatva, is it illogical? Is that what you are saying? Or are you saying Abhanadva? No, there is no Anubhava of that kind of a Adhyasa. We say that this Anubhava Siddhattvam is there. But if are you saying that there is no Anubhava Abhanad? Or are you saying there is no Karana for Adhyasa? So Karana Bhavadva. These are the three options given by the Siddhanti to the Purvapakshi to show his understanding of why Adhyasa is Mithya isn't there. Adhya Ishta Ityaha. So Adhye. In the first paksha of the three, which is Ayuktatvad, illogical. Ishta Ityaha Tathapi Iti. Ishta means we agree. In fact, this is not a dosha, this is a bhushana. So this is not a dushana, it is a bhushana. If you say Adhyasa is illogical, we say yes, it is illogical. It shouldn't be. Yes, we say it shouldn't be. That is why this Puropakshi Bhashya appears like Siddhanti, because all the logic which has been given sounds very very familiar. It is like the Siddhanti's argument. So, so far we do agree. But if he says it is mithya, it is not there, then we do not agree. Because anubhava is there. So, adhyasa shouldn't be there, so far we are with you. But if you say adhyasa is not there, we are not with you. So, that is the subtle difference there. That's why you can read the adhyasa bhashya beginning as akshepa also and as siddhanti also. Akshepa is that it is not there, adhyasa. Whereas siddhanti says, so far you are right, but adhyasa is there. It shouldn't be there, but it is there. Tam prakasha vad viruddha swabhava is there. Yes. Aikya is not possible between tama and prakasha, between atma and anatma and their respective dharmas. You cannot have aikya. Shouldn't be there. We do agree. But it is there. You can see in the realm of Vyavaharika Jagradavastha, you can't fly. But in the dream, you can be flying. So logically, you should not be able to fly. But in the dream, do you fly? Yes. So Kalpita, flying is possible. Therefore, adhyasa isn't there, shouldn't be there, but isn't there, you cannot say. Kalpita, is it possible as a kalpana? Something you have to accept because there is anubhava, swapna anubhava is there. You know that I dreamt that I was flying. When you are flying, you are not dreaming. You are the waker in the dream. The dreamer does not consider himself as dreaming. He considers himself as waking. So the waker sleeps, dreams that he is a waker and he is flying. That is an anubhava. Cannot be denied. But when you wake up, you say, no, it was mithya. Why? You are flying. Of course, that flying does not continue in the waking. Or even if you were walking in a different area where you have not slept, you wake up in your bed, but you have been walking at your workplace. In the dream. So you think that it is mithya. You know that it is mithya on waking up. But during the dream, you cannot say that anubhava is invalid. So now with that basis, let's look at tathapi in the bhashya. I don't want to scroll through pages. So let's go to Advaita Sharada. So we have seen this sentence. Yushmadasmat pratyaya gocharayor vishay vishay noho tamah prakashavad virudda svabhavayor itaretara bhavanupattau siddhayam. तद् धर्माण अपि सुतराम इतरेतर भावानुपत्तिः इत्यतः अस्मत् प्रत्ययगोचरे विषयिणी चिदात्मके युष्मत् प्रत्ययगोचरस्य विषयस्य तद्धर्माणां च अध्यासः तद्विपर्येण विषयिणः तद्धर्माणां च विषय अध्यासो मिथ्या इति भवितुं युक्तम्. नाउ तथापि, सो सिंस तथापि इज देयर तथा, सो वी कैन read the connection. Tathapi, although it is so, even so, tathapi. So here you see in the Ratna Prabha, he says yadyapi iti patitavyam. So you can say yadyapi yushmadasmat pratyegochari etc. all that, and then mithya iti bhavitum yuktam. Yadyapi mithya iti bhavitum yuktam. Yadyapi तमः प्रकाशवत् विरुद्ध स्वभावत्वात् मिथ्या इति भवितुं युक्तम्. ऑल दैट युष्मत् प्रत्यय गोचरे अस्मत् प्रत्यय गोचरस्य तद्धर्माणां च अध्यासः एंड अस्मत् प्रत्यय गोचरे युष्मत् प्रत्यय गोचरस्य तद्धर्माणां च अध्यासः मिथ्या इति भवितुं युक्तम् यद्यपि तथा तथापि. सो यद्यपि इवन इफ इट शुड बी मिथ्या स्टिल व्हाट तथापि अन्योन्यस्मिन् अन्योन्यात्मकताम् अन्योन्यधर्मांच अध्यस्य इतरेतरा विवेकेन अत्यंत विविक्तयोर् धर्मधर्मिणोः मिथ्याज्ञाननिमित्त सत्यानृते मिथुनीकृत्य अहमिदं ममेदमिति नैसर्गिकोऽयं लोकव्यवहारः. सो अयं लोकव्यवहारः, दिस् व्यवहार इन् दि लोक आफ् दि लोक आफ् दि पीपल्, वाट् कैंड ऑफ अ व्यवहार. Aham idam, mama idam. When you say, I am this man or a woman, I am this person, I am a human being with a man's body, with a woman's body, playing a particular role, not knowing that it is a role. I claim myself to be the Sharira itself. I am tall, I am thin, I am short, I am stout, I am dark, I am fair. So these are all what? Annamaya Kosha Dharmas. I am hungry, I am thirsty. These are all Pranamaya Kosha Dharmas. I am sad, I am elated, I am angry, I am jealous, I am compassionate. All these are Manomaya Kosha Dharmas. Oh, I am so brilliant, I am a dullard, I am a Mandha Adhikari, I am an Uttama Adhikari. All these are what? Based on this Antakkarana, where I am not able to understand anything, so it is playing the role of Buddhi, Vijnanamaya Kosha Dharmas. Then, all this Priyamoda, Pramoda, all the gradations of happiness based on the Vishaya, all this is Anandamaya Kosha, Ananda manifest with gradations, degrees of happiness. So I am not as happy as I was in my childhood. This is all what Anandamaya Kosha Dharma. But when I say I am, I am, I am, all that shows Adhyasa. Even the other Darshanikas, including Nayayika, will boldly claim as Atma is different from the Sharira. That being so, how can he deny Adhyasa? Then once you have taken yourself to the body mind sense, to be the body mind sense complex, then anything related to the body mind sense complex will also claim as ours. Therefore, mama idam, mama pita, mama mata, mama putra, mama putri, mama mitram. All these mama, 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 mamata is also from what? It is from ahankara in the sharira. Then anything related to the sharira, which is not you, how can that be yours? Something else which is related to the sharira. Sharira is not you. Just because someone owns something, it doesn't become yours. Someone has a relation with something else, you, that something else does not become yours, because that someone else or something else is not you. But still, naisargiko ayam loka vyavaharaha. Nobody even thinks twice. Nobody thinks even once also, let alone twice. Naturally, there is a claim over the body as oneself and anything related to the body as one's own. Therefore, what has been said, tathapi, even though it shouldn't be so, but it is so, it is anubhava siddha by loka vyavahara, naisargika loka vyavahara. So, tathapi, what kind of situation has arisen here? Anyonyasmin anyona atma katam. So, anyonyasmin, mutually on each other, atma and anatma, anyonya atma katam. Those which do not belong to themselves. So, their swarupa. Atma is not anatma, anatma is not atma, but the swarupa itself, dharmi, is mutually superimposed. Mithuni kritya. So, there will be a mix-up. There is a mix-up of atma and anatma mutually, and anyonya dharmanscha adhyasya. And mutual dharmas also having done adhyasa. So adhyasya yavanta. Then what happens? Once there is dharmi adhyasa and dharma adhyasa between atma and anatma and their respective dharmas, then one cannot differentiate between the two. They have as though become one. Therefore, Mithuni Kritya follows. Here, having an adhyasa between atma and anatma and their dharmas, then itaretara aviveka takes place. One is not able to discriminate between just like in the example of Ayogolaka. So Taptayogolaka, the iron ball is heated. Once it is heated to such an extent that it starts glowing red, the iron does not have redness of its own. Swarupa of the dharmi, the iron ball Ayogolaka, is not redness. It does not have that red guna, and swarupa is not the fire swarupa. Agni swarupa isn't there in the Ayogolaka. But still, if you touch the Ayogolaka, it will burn. It will appear red as well. Similarly, the fire does not have a shape. But the fire will say, oh, look at that red ball of fire. There is no red ball of fire. There is a red ball of iron. But Vyavahara is there. Vyavahara is that there is a red ball of fire. The fire cannot have the ball shape. It is the shape of the iron. So Swarupa mix-up is there and Dharma mix-up is also there. It is not possible to differentiate. Although we know that the iron does not burn on its own, the iron does not appear red, we also know that the fire does not have the shape of the ball. But still, there is aviveka. Similarly, in the case of Atma and Anatma, itare-itara avivekena, we cannot differentiate between Atma and Anatma and their dharmas also. Atyanta viviktayoho dharma dhirminoho. What kind of these are mixed up, which are atyanta vivikta? We are unable to differentiate between those which are completely different from each other. There is no overlap possible. There is no mix-up possible which has already been established. Tamav prakashavad viruddha swabhava they have, and still atyanta, completely different from each other, we have managed to mix up. How? Naturally. Naisargika. Therefore, atyanta vivikthayor dharma dharmino ho. Dharma and dharmis both have got mixed up. Mithyajnana nimitta. Why? Mithyajnana nimitta satyanrute mithuni krityav. The atma is satya. Anatma is anruta. It is not satya. Mithuni krutya, having mixed them up as one. What is the reason? Mithyajnana nimittaha. So adhyasa, this adhyasa is mithyajnana nimittaha. Or this, due to this adhyasa, what happens? Adhyasya is there, yabanta is there. So adhyasya mithuni krutya naisargikaha ayam lokavyavahara. So lokavyavahara mithyajnana nimittaha. Ayam lokavyavahara. Ayam shows anubhava siddha. Ayam, aham idam, mama idam iti ayam. Yaha lokavyavahara sa naisargika api. Kena karanana bhavati kinnimittaha mithyajnana nimittaha lokavyavaharaha. So this lokavyavahara is there. Aham idam mama idam. Is it possible without adhyasa? No. Mithyajnana nimittaha. We'll look at what mithyajnana means in the Vyakhyantika. So mithyajnanam nimittam yasya lokavyavaharasya saha lokavyavahara mithyajnana nimittaha. So this shows there is an adhyasa. Preceding this Mishrikarana, Mithunikarana, there has to be adhyasa before. You are unable to separate. Helplessly becomes one. So this is the Bhashya. We'll look at more in the Tika. I don't want to spend more time in the Bhashya itself, because Tika will explain all these in further detail. Vyakhya and Tika. So going back to Tathahi in the Tathapi. Tathapi in the Ratna Prabha. Adhya Ishta Ityaha, out of the three options, why adhyasa is not possible? Why do you say so? Is it because it is ayukta, illogical? Yes. इफ इट इज अयुक्त देन वी एग्री इट इज अयुक्त आद्येष्ट इत्याह तथापि इवन तथापि शोज यद्यपि यद्यपि न भवितुम युक्तम तथापि भवति एव सो मिथ्या अध्यास मिथ्या इति भवितुम युक्तम यद्यपि तथापि अध्यासो भवति therefore we agree it is illogical what about this so etat anurodha adau yadyapi iti patitavyam because of this construct of the sentence you have to use yadyapi because tathapi is a correlative yadyapi will be the relative there so yadyapi iti patitavyam adhyasasya asanga swaprakashaatmani ayuktatvam alankara iti bhava so it is not a dosha it is an alankara It is not a dushana, it is a bhushana. We say yes, we agree. You can't point it out as a flaw. We agree, and this is how the situation is. So it is illogical, and that is why logic is not sufficient. You have to go to shruti. Anubhava shows you something which fails logic. Then you have to go to the shruti to understand what is a fact. What is the truth? Therefore, in Asanga Atma, as revealed by the Shruti, which is Swayam Prakasha, in that seeing this Anatma and Anatma Dharma by Anubhava shouldn't be there, Ayukta. Therefore, that Ayuktatvam is Alankara iti Bhava. Tika. Angikara Artha. अंगीकार अर्थ केन तथापि इत्यनेन एव आद्य पक्षे परिहारो वेदितव्यः सो व्हाट हैज बीन सेड इज दैट हाउ डू यू नो इन द भाष्य इट हैज बीन रिफ्यूटेड एज इन द फर्स्ट ऑब्जेक्शन हैज बीन रिफ्यूटेड बाय सेइंग दैट आई एग्री बिकॉज तथापि सेज सो सो बाय रीडिंग तथापि इटसेल्फ बाय इन द भाष्य बाय भगवान भाष्यकर एडिंग तथापि ही इज सेइंग दैट आई एग्री विथ योर ऑब्जेक्शन सो तथापि इति इत्यनेन एव आद्य पक्षे परिहारो वेदितव्यः देयर इटसेल्फ परिहार इज गिवन यस वी एग्री दैट इज द परिहार आदौ इति युष्मद् अस्मद् इत्यादि भाष्यस्य आदौ इत्यर्थ आदौ मीन्स वेयर शुड यू एड यद्यपि एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द भाष्य अर्थक्रमस्य पाठक्रमापेक्षया प्रबलत्वाद् अर्थक्रम अनुसृत्य क्रमेण पदान पदानि अवतारयति न इत्यादिना इन संस्कृत यू कैन हैव यू नो एनी वर्ड एनीवेयर एज अ डिक्लाइंड पद इट विल हैव इन अदर लैंग्वेजेस व्हाट यू हैव एज यू नो द ऑल द कनेक्टर्स आर विद इन सो ऑल द What do you say? I forget the word now. Anyway, so the declined word itself has a cases will tell you what is the connection with the other words. How the anvaya is will be revealed by the declensions themselves. So the words can be placed anywhere. There is no particular anvaya. All for easy understanding we do make anvayas, but then any word can be anywhere and still connect with a similar construct as the other. The same construct as the other. The same meaning will be revealed by the sentence. Vakyartha or Shabda Bodha will be the same, however the word formation is. That being so, in Mimamsa, when you are doing Mimamsa, that time you have to see what connects with what for Shabda Bodha. Whether the sentence is incomplete, do you need to borrow something from somewhere else and complete the sentence? Do you need to supply something to make sense? All this is by Akanksha Yogyata Ityadi. Now, what has been said is that Arthakramasya Patakramapekshaya Pravalatvad. Just because you start reading the sentence and then you try to understand it and are unable to make sense, it does not mean that that is how it is. You have to complete the sentence. Arthakrama, especially in Purva Mimamsa, you look at it. You are looking at some sections where what is mentioned, some ingredients are mentioned, some samagri is mentioned as to how the havana has to be done. Now these are spread across the Veda. Even if it is in the same place, it may not be said in order. You have to put them in the order. If someone says, for example, simple, simple cooking process also. You know, somebody's mother tells, so Devadatta's mother tells him, you cook it in this manner, you add this, you add this, you add this. And then she says, oh wait, in the beginning you have to do this as well. So when that is said, he cannot just start off. When he starts hearing her instructions, he can't just start off. He has to make notes and then put them in the right order, because she'll tell you as she remembers. She'll tell him as she remembers, because she is used to cooking in that manner. She won't even recall. She won't have a procedure where she says, okay, I have to do this first and then this. It is all automatic for her, as though. So something which is forgotten out of sequence should not be done out of sequence. Arthakrama will supersede the Padakrama. So Patakrama. Here also that applies. In Havana, if something has been said, you have to do this. But then before that you have to do this. Then, or even if before that it is not mentioned, it is not possible to. If it says that you add cooked rice, but then how that rice should be cooked, that instruction comes later. So obviously that should follow, that should precede the offering itself. Anyway, so arthakramasya padakramapekshya prabalottvad. If there is some contradiction which is apparent, then to resolve that you have to start with the arthakrama. Here, many interpretations are possible, but then at least in the beginning, what he does is arthakrama anusrutya kramena padani avatarayati. Just because the words in the Bhashya have come in this manner does not mean that he has to do Pada Bhashya. Bhagavan Bhashyakara does Pada Bhashya, sometimes he goes other way around. Similarly, Vyakhyanakara need not necessarily do Pada Bhashya. He can do Artha Bhashya also, Artha Vyakhya. So, Kramena Padani Avatarayati Na Ityadina. So, Na Dvitiya Ityaha. Meaning, the Artha Krama is in this manner. The objection has been interpreted as having three options. So Ayuktatvam, Abhana and Abhana and Karana Bhava. These are the three possibilities. So Na Dvitiyaha. Then Ayam. Ayam is a word which happens to be at the end of the Bhashya. Ayam Loka Vyavaharaha. Started with Tathapi. Tathapi takes away the first objection, Ayuktatvam. But the second of Abhana option of the Purapakshi has been refuted in the end of the sentence, at the end of the sentence in the Bhashya. So Ayamiti Loka Vyavahara, that is the Patakrama. If you go by Patakrama, it is at the end. But you go by Arthakrama, that Ayam will fit in right here. Thereby Na Dvitiya Ityaha Ayamiti. When Bhagavan Bhashyakara says Aham idam mamedam iti naisariko ayam loka vyavaharaha, there ayam itself refutes this second option, abhanad. Ayam. Ayam is pratyaksha, anubhava siddha. Aham idam mamedam is pratyaksha to each of the persons. Therefore, ayam iti loka vyavahara itself shows that abhana is not possible. There is bhana of adhyasa. How so? Further elaboration is in Ajnaha Karta Manishyoham Iti Pratyakshanubhavad Adhyasasya Abhana Masiddham Ityartha. This Abhana that Puropakshi says, Adhyasa Bhana is not, Adhyasa Bhana isn't there. We don't have Anubhav of Adhyasa, that is erroneous. Why so? Because Ajnaha Karta Manishyaham, all these show, the Loka Vyavahara itself shows there is Bhana Anubhava of Adhyasa. Because when you say Ajnaha, Atma is Jnana Swarupa. Jnaha, Atma is Jnaha. Whereas you say Aham Ajnaha, Atma is Akarta. But what do you say? Aham Karta. Then Atma cannot be Manushya, Prani, Ityadi. Atma is free from any of these dharmas, any of these shariras also. So Manushya, Aham, Manushya, Sharira, you are claiming yourself, Aham Manushya. Then that Aham being Atma, which is Jnaha, Akarta and Amanushya, there you say you are Ajnaha, karta and manushya. That itself shows you there is anubhava of adhyasa. Iti pratyaksha anubhavat. There is pratyaksha anubhava. You cannot say logically I deny it, and therefore there is no bhana also you cannot say. Adhyasasya abhanam asiddham. So objection, it's a asiddha hetu. Tika ayam iti pratyakshatmaka anubhava siddha ityartha. This ayam meaning pratyaksha anubhava siddha. Adhyasa is directly known to each and every person. There is an anubhava. Ayam ityanena eva dvitiya kalpa pariharo drashtavya. Just like tathapi took away the first option in the objection. Similarly, ayam itself takes away. In the bhashya, by saying ayam itself, Bhagavan Bhashyakara has refuted the second possibility also. So pratyaksha anubhavad iti. There is a pratyaksha anubhava. Sakshi rupa pratyaksha anubhava vishayatvad ityartha. Where is the anubhava? Purvapakshi says, I don't have this anubhava. Ajna, karta, manushyaha, I don't know through any indriyas. We are not saying that this pratyaksha is through indriya pramana. We are saying sakshi is there. You are the sakshi. You yourself know the vrittis. For vrittis, ajna vritti, kartra kartru vritti. In any vritti, do you have this kartrutva bhava? That I am the karta of some kriya, pramata of some jnana, prameya, of a jnaya vastu, not jnana, jnaya. But then jnana is also known. Jnaya is known. Similarly, the pramata is known. Prameya is known. Jnata is known. Karta is known. These are all upalakshana. It is not necessarily necessarily limited to ajna, karta, manushya. So you can read adi there. Ham ityadi. So ityadi pratyaksha anubhavad. We can read that. It can be extended to every anubhava that we have with the body, mind, sense complex. It is all known through what? Through vritti. And that vritti taking place in antakkarana is lit up by the sakshi. Sakshi reflects there. There is a pratibimba. Thereby, sakshi rupa pratyaksha anubhava vishayatvad. This ajnyatvam, kartrutvam, manushyatvam, which is not there in the atma, which appears to be in the vritti, that is lit up by, that becomes the vishaya for the sakshi. Therefore, sakshi rupa pratyaksha anubhava vishayatvad tesham. Thereby, you cannot say there is no pratyaksha anubhava. Sakshi pratyaksha it is. Aham ajna ityadi vritti rupasya anubhavasya brahma swarupatvad adhyasa siddha. Okay, anubhava is there, sakshi. Sakshi pratyaksha it is. How can it be adhyasa? How do you say it is adhyasa? If this is the question of the Purvapakshi, the Siddhant, this is aham ajna. When you say ajna, aham ajna, ityadi vritti rupasya anubhavasya, that anubhava is vrityatmaka. Vritti is lit up by the sakshi, and then you are unable to differentiate because you have become one with that pratibimba and you claim yourself to be the karta. What has happened there is that tasya anubhavasya brahma swarupatvad. It is a brahma. Shruti says that you are akarta, you are a jnana swarupa, chit swarupa, jnaha rupa atma, akarta and amanushya. Whereas you think yourself as ajnaha, etc. Therefore, what is really your swarupa you aren't claiming. You are claiming yourself to be opposite to what is your swarupa. Therefore, it is a brahma. Brahma swarupatva, this anubhava is there, and that anubhava is not satya anubhava. It is brahma. Therefore, brahma swarupatva, what will it be? It is adhyasa only. You cannot say it is not adhyasa, although you have anubhava, sakshi pratyaksha it is, but it is not adhyasa, you cannot say. Why? Because it is counter to your swarupa. Therefore, it is a brahma, and what is a brahma is अध्यासादेर अध्यास सिद्ध सिद्धे वृत्ति स्वरूपे अध्यासे साक्षात्मक भान सत्वाद अभानम अयुक्तम। सो व्हाट इज साक्षी प्रत्यक्ष, यू कैन नॉट से दैट अध्यास इज साक्षी प्रत्यक्ष बट देर इज नो भान, देर फोर अभानम अयुक्तम। वृत्ति नाम साक्षी भाष्यत्व नियमादिति भावः, सिंस वृत्ति इज लिट अप बाय द साक्षी, दिस अध्यास इट इज अ भ्रम, भ्रम वृत्ति, भ्रम वृत्ति शोज अध्यास, देयर फोर यू कैन नॉट से अध्यास अभान इज देयर। जीवात्मनि कर्तृत्वादिकं वास्तवमेव इत्याशंक्य निषेधति। इफ द पूर्व पक्षी सेज नो देयर इज नो अध्यास, दिस इज दिस कर्तृत्व इज मय स्वरूप, जीवात्म स्वरूप। सो इन जीवात्म कर्तृत्वादि धर्मास अज्ञत्वम कर्तृत्वादित्वम कर्तृत्वम मनुष्यत्वम दीज आर ऑल रियल, इफ यू से सो देन निषेरति नच इत्यादिना। रत्नप्रभा नच इदं प्रत्यक्षं कर्तृत्वादौ प्रमा इति वाच्यम्। नो यू शुड नॉट से दैट सेज सिद्धांति टू द पूर्व पक्षी, यू शुड नॉट से दैट प्रत्यक्ष साक्षी प्रत्यक्ष अज्ञा कर्ता मनुष्यहम, दिस इज प्रमा, कर्तृत्वादौ प्रमा इति न वाच्यम्, यू शुड नॉट से दैट। वाय अपौरुषेतया निर्दोषेण उपक्रमादि लिंगावद्धृत तात्पर्येण च तत्त्वमसि इत्यादि वाक्येन अकर्तृत्व ब्रह्मत्व बोधनेन अस्य भ्रमत्व निश्चयात्। बिकॉज़ देयर इज श्रुति प्रमाण, श्रुति टेल्स यू दैट यू आर तत्त्वमसि मीनिंग यू आर तत्, यू आर ब्रह्म, यू आर सच्चिदानंद ब्रह्म इन दी एंड, इट बाय लक्षण तत्त्वमसि टेल्स यू दैट यू आर सच्चिदानंद ब्रह्म। वाई शुड आई एग्री विथ श्रुति दैट क्वेश्चन, इफ एट ऑल इट कम्स अप देन आई हैव कर्तृत्व अनुभव। श्रुति सेज आई एम नॉट अ कर्ता, आई एम सच्चिदानंद असंग आत्मा। If the Purva Pakshi were to say that my Anubhava is Prabala Pramana, I don't agree with Shruti, then, or he quotes something else. If at all you imagine he quotes something else also, even then, any Paurushaya Grantha will not stand scrutiny in front of Apaurushaya Grantha. Paurushaya Granthas have flaws. Or if the Purva Pakshi were to object also, not quoting some other grantha, but he just says that, why should I agree with Shruti? Someone says, I don't have to agree with someone saying something. So Rishi says something in the Shruti, why do I have to agree? I have Anubhava, I will hold on to my Anubhava of Kartrutva. You cannot do that. Why? Because it is not someone saying. It is not the Rishi saying. That Rishi is not the Karta. Ishwara himself is not the Karta. He has recreated the Shruti, Vedas, Veda Vedanta, Upanishad, the way it was there in the earlier Kalpa. Tasya Nishwasito. So like the Nishwasa of the Ishwara. Meaning, as easily as one breathes, so easily has Ishwara re-manifests this Shruti in this Kalpa the way it was there in the earlier Kalpa. So it is apaurushiya. It is not a product of a Purusha. So no person, even a special person, has not made it. It is not left to your Shraddha. It is a fact. If you have Shraddha, you will benefit. But just because you do not have Shraddha will not make it subject to flaws, let alone lie. It will not be subject to flaws even. Because the flaws are due to Purusha doshas. The dosha in the Paurusheya Grantha is due to Purusha doshas. In the Apaurusheya Grantha, you cannot have Purusha doshas. They say that if you are jaundiced, then you see the world yellow. Or, you know, if all you have a hammer, everything looks like a nail. See, you look at the world tainted because Our mind is tainted, we look at the world tainted. Easily said, in a sense, the world may be flawed, but what we are looking at is also flawed because we have colored lenses. So now, the Purvapakshi is saying, why should I agree with it? It may be a lie. It may be due to some kind of a fame. It may be due to unknown flaws also. What is my anubhava cannot be denied by someone else. If that is the argument, that is an argument based on our own thinking that we have flaws. Human beings have flaws. We can be jealous. We want fame. We can make unknown mistakes. We can make purposeful mistakes. We can purposefully add something. We can lie to get what we want. But Shruti has enough that. Why? Apurushayatvat. So that is the hetu there. Apurushayataya. That is a hetu there. Hetu tritiya. Nirdoshena. So for nirdosha, what is the hetu? Apurushayatvam. There are no doshas in the Shruti. So what Shruti says is the final word. Then, okay, Shruti says so many things. How do you know that this is the Tatparya Vishaya? So there you have to apply logic. Yes, your logic is important, but not logically establishing against Shruti. For the Tatparya Vishaya of the Shruti, you have logic as a tool. So use that logic not to say that the Shruti is flawed, but to show that what is the Tatparya Vishaya in the Shruti? Shruti talks about so many things which may be known to you also. There it is not Pramana. But what is not known to you, there Shruti is Pramana. And thereby what? What is the Tatparya Vishaya? In this Tattvamasi, this Tattvamasi statement is the Tatparya Vishaya. How do you know? Across so many Karma Kanda and Jnana Kanda, Upasana Kanda statements. There, Siddhanti says, Upakramadi Linga Avadhruta Tatparyena cha. This Tatparya has been arrived at by Upakramadi Shadlinga process. We have seen this, so I will not repeat this. It will be talked about in the Tika a bit, but then we will not look at details because we have seen this in the beginning of the Adhyasa Bhashya Pathas. So that is the Tatparya. Upakrama, Upasamhara, Ityadi, Shadlingas are there. Thereby we have logically analyzed and landed on Tattvamasi. Therefore, Tattvamasi is a fact. And it is a Tatparya Vishaya of the Shruti. It cannot be known by any other means. So you cannot claim that I have Anubhava otherwise. Everyone has Anubhava otherwise. So you have to inquire into that Anubhava as to whether it is fact or not. Shruti tells you it is otherwise. So you have to inquire the way Shruti has said and then you will be led to the truth by hand-holding. Nacha jyeshta pratyaksha virodhad agamajnana seva bada iti vachyam. Now if you are further to argue that okay, let Shruti say so, I agree it is a Tatparya Vishaya of the Shruti, but I have Prabala Pramana. Pratyaksha is a Prabala Jyeshta Pramana. Like an elder brother saying, the younger one has to agree. These days, if not due to Shraddha or due to the cultural impact, but then you will say that the younger one is weaker than the elder. So if that is the claim, Jyeshta Pratyaksha, Pratyaksha is a Jyeshta Pramana. Even Shruti is based on Shravana, and Shravana is not possible without Indriyas. Shrotrendriya is there. So Pratyaksha of the Shruti is also through the Pratyaksha Karana, Pramana in the form of Shrotrendriya. So these are the arguments made by Dvaitins also, by the way. So nacha jyeshta pratyaksha virodha. Pratyaksha pramana is a jyeshta pramana, and Shruti saying tattvamasi is countering my jyeshta pramana, whereby I know this pratyaksha. Pratyakshena I know that I am karta. Thereby nacha jyeshta pratyaksha virodhad agamajnana seva bada iti vachyam. So when Tulya Pramana Bala is there. Shruti is a Shabda Pramana. And I have Pratyaksha Pramana. So Pramana Tulyatvam is there, which will be superior. Meaning the Shruti says that appears valid. because it is a pramana, and I have pratyaksha pramana which says something against it, that is also apparently valid. So when there are two equally valid arguments but they are opposite to each other, then tulya pramana virodha, is it there tulyatvam? Purva pakshi says no tulyatvam, jyeshta pratyaksha is jyeshta. So it will supersede, and therefore there will be badha of agama jnana itself. Agama jnana is veda jnana, vedanta jnana. There will be badha because of agama jnana being dependent on shravana indriya, shrotra indriya. Iti na vachyam. Nacha vachyam, you should not say that. Why? Dehatmavada prasangat. Siddhanti says if you are to argue in this manner, then you are no different than the charvakas. Charvakas also say the same thing. They say that I'll believe what I see, I'll believe what I hear, and that is what you are doing. You are saying that karta aham, ajna aham, manushya aham, this is pratyaksha. I don't care if the Shruti says so, because why? Pratyaksha pramana is superior. They also do the same thing. The only difference is that you say that, yeah, Shruti is also pramana, okay. They say that Shruti is not a pramana. But your behavior is the same. How so? Because they say that I'll depend on pratyaksha. Pratyaksha is the only pramana. Now if you say pratyaksha is the pramana here, which will supersede everything that the Shruti says, then how different are you from them? You are just giving lip service to pramanyam of the Shruti. You are not really valuing the Shruti. Thereby, dehatmavada prasangat. Dehatmavada is charvakavada. Deha eva atma. So, deha eva atma iti vadaha, dehatmavada. That kind of situation you land yourself into. Tika, aham karta ityadi pratyaksham kartrutvadi mat. Aham karta ityadi pratyaksham kartrutvadi mat. Atma visheshyaka kartrutvadi prakarakatvat pramatmakam. Eva na adhyasatmakam, ataha adhyasana anubhavasiddha ityartha. So the objection of the Purvapakshi, even after saying that there is a sakshi pratyaksha, he says that no, there is no adhyasa, this is a real jnana. So, because there is, you say sakshi pratyaksha, whatever you say, first, there is no pratyakshatvam. Once sakshi pratyakshatvam is shown, then that sakshi pratyakshatvam is what? Aham karta. Then he says aham karta, aham manushya is real. If it is pratyaksha, it is real. Then it is not adhyasa. You are saying that sakshi pratyaksha is there, therefore adhyasa is pratyaksha. Purvapakshi says adhyasa is not pratyaksha. Sakshi pratyaksha let bhavatu. Let it be sakshi pratyaksha, but still it is not adhyasa, it is real. It is a prama. विशेषणद्वयेन तत्त्वमस्यादि वाक्येन सॉरी अनुभवसिद्ध इत्यर्थ न अनुभवसिद्ध सो अनुभवसिद्ध अध्यास इज नॉट अनुभवसिद्ध सॉरी विशेषणद्वयेन तत्त्वमस्यादि वाक्यस्य अप्रामाण्य अन्यपरत्वयोः निरासः क्रियते सो विशेषणद्वयेन अपौरुषेयतया निर्दोषेण उपक्रमादि लिंगावधृत तात्पर्येण च सो दिस कैन बी टेकन एज विशेषणद्वयेन तत्त्वमस्यादि वाक्यस्य अप्रामाण्य अन्यपरत्वयोः अप्रामाण्य तत्त्वस्य तत्त्वमसि दिस वाक्य इज अप्रामाण्यम और व्हाट अन्यपरत्व इट हैज डिपेंडेंसी ऑन समथिंग एल्स निराशा तयोः निराशा क्रियते दीज काइंड ऑफ ऑब्जेक्शंस आर टेकन अवे इन दी रत्न प्रवाह बाय शोइंग व्हाट हेतुस टू हेतुस विशेषणद्वयेन हेतु विशेषणद्वयेन हेतु गर्भ विशेषणद्वयेन सो देयर इज अपौरुषेयतया निर्दोषेण एंड उपक्रमादि लिंगावधृत तात्पर्येण च बोथ दीज विशेषणाज आर हेतु गर्भ विशेषणाज एंड देयर बाय व्हाट दे शो इज दैट अप्रामाण्यम ऑफ श्रुति इज नॉट पॉसिबल वाई बिकॉज इट इज निर्दोष वाई इज इट निर्दोष अपौरुषेय ओके वॉट अबाउट हैविंग डिपेंडेंसी or sorry anya paratva is not dependency, anya paratva is committed to something else. Anya paratva, paratvam, there is commitment. This the, what is the conclusion? Kim paraha Upanishad kim para, if that is the question. Or tattvamasya vakya itself, tattvamasi kim para, tattvamasi iti vakyam kim param, what is it committed to reveal? So anya paratvam is not committed, meaning does not have swartha. Swartha tatparya isn't there. It is like the puro mimamsaka would say, it is arthavada. And what kind of arthavada? It is not swartha arthavada. Swarupena, there is no sense of the vakya. It has dependency. So thereby dependency also. Anya paratvam is revealing, is committed to something else because it has dependency on some other sentence. To interpret this, you will need some other sentence. What does that he say? The Puro-Vimamsaka says that Tattvamasi is just going to praise the is Arthavada, there is Stuti, Stuti Para. So it does Stuti of the Karta. Oh, you are Brahma, you can do anything. And then it says that anything is this Karma. So you do Agnihotradi Karma. Entire day you spend in your karma so that you can get swarga. So that is the anya paratvam. No, it is not so. Why? Because upakramadi linga avadhruta tatparya is there. We have done this analysis. You do that, you will know that tattvamasi has swartha. Upakrama upasamhara abhyaso purvata phalam arthavada upapatti cha lingam tatparya nirane iti shlokokta upakramadi padena grahyam upakrama upasamharau eva lingam. So it begins the Chandogya Shashto Adhyaya where you have Tattvamasi Mahavakya. You apply the upakramadi shadlinga, then you will see upakrama and upasamhara, the beginning and the end is leading to the Tattvamasi statement itself. So that is the commitment. There is no anya paratvam. There is swaparatvam. Bodhanena, so bodhanena, brahmatva bodhanena, akartrutva brahmatva bodhanena. Through this vakya, the akartrutvam of atma, brahmatvam of atma is revealed. And through that knowledge, bodhanena, jnanena ityartha. So through jnanena, niratnaprabha, tattvamasi ityadi vakyena akartrutva. Brahmatva of Atma, Jnana takes place. So, Tena Jnanena, Bodhanena, Jnanena, Asya Brahmatva Nishchayat. When that Jnana takes place, it will show that Akarta Aham is countering Karta Aham. So, that Karta Aham is a Brahma. It will lead to a Nishchaya. You will be sure that I am not a Karta. Akarta Anuhava is there, Sakshi Pratyaksha, I have this Adhyasa though, not I am Karta, but I am Karta is an Adhyasa. It will be proven by Shruti statement, by Shabda Pramana that you are not a Karta, you are Akarta. You are not Karta, you are Akarta. Thereby, Shadlinga Tatparya will lead you there. Bodhanena Jnana Nityartha Vyadhikaraniyam Tritiya. Tathacha, so Vyadhikaranim Tritiya, there the Tritiya which has been Apaurushetaya, Nirdoshena Upakramadi, Lingavadrita, and then sorry, here, Bodhana, Vakyena. So Ityadi Vakyena, Bodhanena. So Vakyena, Bodhanena, they are not in Samanadikarana, that's all it is said. So Vyadhikarana, Vyadhikarana Tritiya, Vyadhikaraniyam Tritiya, Tathacha, Jivasya Akartru Brahmatva. So Akartrutva Brahmatva, Akartru Brahmatva. So you have to take this tva here as well with the karta, kartru also. So akartrutva brahmatva. Together akartru brahmatva bodhaka agama vakya janya jnanena aham karta ityadi pratyakshasya brahmatva nishchayad adhyasa siddhirti bhavaha. Since the Shruti says that you are not karta, you are akarta, therefore the anubhava which is there, karta, aham karta, that will be negated and then Brahmatva Nishchaya will take place. Therefore, Adhyasa Nishchaya will take place, Adhyasa Siddhi will take place, iti bhava. Prasangam eva upapadayati. Then further he elaborates the same context as to manushyoham iti pratyaksha virodena atha ayam ashariraha. I'll just flip the page and stop. Ityadi shrutya deha deha anya atma siddhehe. So here in the manushyaham iti pratyaksha virodena, manushyaham, that is pratyaksha, and pratyaksha virodhena atha ayam ashariraha. I am ashariraha. Manushyaham is I am shariri. I am sharirasya asti iti. Sharira also is possible. Generally we will say shariri. Shariraha asya asti. Shariram asya asti iti shariraha. May be possible by harshadibhyo ach. So with that ach pratyaya, you may get this sharira also. But ashariraha, shariram avidyamanam yasya sa ashariraha. Brahadaranyaka Shruti says atha ayam ashariraha, ayam atma ashariraha. But manushyaham is pratyaksha, whereas shabda pramana has pratyaksha virodha. So iti pratyaksha virodena atha ayam ashariraha ityadi shrutya dehanya atma asiddhehe. I'll look this up. Dehanya atma asiddhe. Pratyaksha, with pratyaksha prama you will say dehanya atma is not possible, but Shruti says that it is possible. So we'll stop here because this I would like to look this up. Dehanya atma asiddhe does not make sense to me. We'll come back to this. Yamiha karunikam sharanam gato apyari sahodarap mahatpadam. Tamaham Ashuharim Paramashri Janakajanka Vananta Sukhakrutim. I may have made a mistake again. Yamiha Karunikam Sharanangato Tamaham Ashuharim Paramashri Janakajanka Vananta Sukhakrutim. Okay. Any questions? Sorry for the delay today. I didn't want to cancel the class. So I thought that later I'll do it. What was that Revati Amma syntax? What is that? See something on the chat.
Arrangement of the words,
no?
That is called syntax.
No, not that. I wanted to say this. What is it called? It is not arrangement of the words. I didn't mean anvaya, but I meant in English, you have a word and then what precedes, what is it called? My God, I use it so frequent, but then it is not coming to mind now.
Is it prepositions?
Yeah, prepositions. Yeah, sorry. Thank you. Okay. So the prepositions, I was saying the prepositions, there are prepositions and postpositions. Some places you have postpositions also, but these prepositions are there inbuilt in the word. That's all I wanted to say. So which is known, okay. But then I was not getting that word preposition in my mind. So thanks. Okay, so I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
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 Namaste.